Here in Jesus, speak of cutting our hands, feet and eyes really scares me. But does he mean that literally?
Some of the early church fathers see the scriptures as a reference to our intimate friends. The real context of this passage is, we ought not to lead others into scandal and sin. In fact, it would be better if we had a great millstone put around our neck and were thrown into the sea, rather than to cause another to sin.
Friends, especially close friends, are most of the blessing, but they can also lead us to sin. If a good friend convinces you to sin, then it is a grave issue. And this is what Jesus is addressing.
What he's trying to say is that if we have close friends who are intentionally and maliciously trying to turn us away from God, it's better if we let go of that friend and cut him off from our life. The hand, the foot, or the eye are symbols of those friends who try to draw us away from God. It's better to end these friendships rather than to be drawn into hell with them. And if we are the friends tempting others to fall in sin, then we must question ourselves.
One thing this passage reveals is the natural and pure bond of friendship. Friendship is a good thing. And when you have a good and very close friend, you feel nice. And you know that he will always be there for you and will be committed to you. You can share your problems with them. Also, you can share your joys with them. That's friendship.
Let's check on our friendships. If you have a close and intimate friend, reflect upon how you influence that person or how he or she influences you. Make sure that God is the center and that good virtues prevail in this natural bond.
Lord, I thank you for giving me all the friendships in my life. I thank you for giving me all those people who care for me. Help me to become a good friend to others also. Lord, I trust in you.